Quantum particles are inherently fuzzy. We can't really pinpoint the position of a particle. What we can say is that there's a certain higher possibility of particle being here than not. Let's call it a barrier. For a classical object like this ball, it is impossible to cross through this barrier and appear on the other side. Unless, of course, it has enough energy to break it. But what happens in case of a quantum particle? Because of its quantumness, it can resolve its position anywhere in this region. And also beyond this barrier. What's more, it can be even found inside the barrier. So what? Does that mean the existence of barrier doesn't affect the quantum particle? It does. There is a certain probability that a particle can be found in a certain location. This probability decreases exponentially across the barrier. So the particle is more likely to be found in this confined region. But it also has a tiny probability of being found outside this barrier. This is what we refer to as quantum tunneling. Similar thing happens in a sun or any star for that matter. A barrier known as Coulomb barrier wouldn't let two protons come close, let alone collide or fuse. But they have to collide to produce the required amount of energy for sun to shine. Quantum tunneling allows them to go through this stubborn barrier and fuse together to make heavier elements and a lot of energy. If it weren't for this quantum nature of every particle in the universe and the fact that their positions are described by wave functions, nuclear fission would never have happened. The majority of today's stars in the universe would never have ignited, including our own. Rather than a world with nuclear fires burning across the cosmos, our universe would be a desolate and frozen with vast majority of stars and solar system unlit by anything.
Thanks for watching, and if you didn't like this video, share it with your friends, tell them how much you hate them. And if you like this video, just maybe consider subscribing, I don't know, maybe.